And now that we've covered pregnancy, which is already a whole minefield of sleep problems, now we're done, right? Sleep can get back to normal. We can sleep soundly again now that the baby is here. Of course, fairy tale, I'm sorry to report. Often patients ask, when will I be able to sleep again? How do we answer them? Well, let's walk through this graph as an answer. There's a lot going on here, so let's walk through together. What we're looking at is sleep efficiency. Generally, higher is better. And the shaded portion, that's first trimester, second, and third, so that's during pregnancy. The bars before that represent pre-pregnancy. The bars after that represent postpartum. The gray bars are first-time moms. Black bars are experienced moms. So this is the healthy zone for sleep efficiency that we're looking for, 85 to 95%. So you see that before pregnancy, great, we're in the healthy zone. During pregnancy, still there, but starting to edge lower. And then the baby is born. And vroom, we drop significantly, dramatically, right? The y-axis does start at 75%, so don't worry, it's not like we don't get any sleep postpartum, but there is a big drop. But luckily, the baby develops their own circadian rhythm by 3 months postpartum, and we can start to get back into the healthy range again. So we can say honestly to our patients, the first 1 to 3 months will be really tough, will be a tough adjustment, lots of time awake at night, but by 3 months, your nighttime sleep efficiency will be close to what you had before pregnancy. So hang in there, you're almost there. What about total nighttime sleep duration? Again, that goes down during pregnancy, as you can see, big hit immediately afterwards. But by 3 months postpartum, especially if you're an experienced mom, you've bounced back to, you know, where we need to be, which is 7 hours or so. And in terms of deep sleep, I actually have bonus good news for you here, which is that during pregnancy, that drops, but hey, immediately after pregnancy, it rises up again. And if you're an experienced mom, that's even higher. So that's at least one good news we can tell people. Now, another question people ask is, what matters more, quantity or quality? Now, of course, the short answer is everything matters. It's all important, definitely. But remember how split the room was when we did the pretest questions, right? We were all over the place. Well, the really fascinating thing is that when it comes to the different sleep variables, nighttime sleep duration, we all assume, or most people assume, that this is the most important variable, but actually it's not. It's these other variables, like how many night awakenings do you have? What's your subjective sleep quality? What's your sleep efficiency? And as we'll see in a little bit, how much light exposure do you get during the day? These factors are actually much more associated with postpartum depression than nighttime sleep duration. So that's good news we can tell people too. If you didn't get that much sleep last night, maybe that's not the worst thing in the world because there are these other factors that may be protective. And also, you can supplement with a nap during the day, right? So that's also very good to know. Another question that patients will often ask is, well, what about breastfeeding? Like, how many of your friends or family have said, you know, oh, I don't know. I'm gonna have to choose between nursing and sleeping because I can't do this anymore, right? But actually, if we really look at the data, breastfeeding moms and their partners get 30 to 45 minutes more sleep, and that's objectively measured sleep, than those feeding formula. Breastfeeding moms actually have more deep sleep than their formula feeding peers and their non-pregnant peers. And this is two separate PSG sleep studies showing this. And there was no difference between sleep through the night moms and getting up to nurse moms. So here, prolactin is probably part of the picture. This is a hormone that we release when we nurse, and this hormone tends to increase your deep sleep and make you sleepier. So that's part of it. And I also suspect that once you get into the groove of nursing, it's actually faster to do that than to make a bottle, feed the baby, clean the bottle. Meanwhile, they've been crying because you got the temperature wrong, so you have to adjust it and blah, blah, blah. So by the end of feeding a bottle, the baby's more upset, taking a long time to get them back to sleep. So then you're up for longer too. So that's what I suspect is going on as well. Now, I do want to pause and say, this is not a hashtag breast is best announcement. I'm very much solidly on the team of whatever works for the family, works for the family. But if someone only is considering stopping nursing because they're afraid of getting less sleep, this is the data we can show them.